The other question is meditation. Meditation is unpremeditated art. Have you got it? Am I right? I said meditation is unpremeditated art. You can't prepare for meditation. There is no system, no method. The system, the method is premeditated. Somebody has thought he has meditated, invented a system, and we follow that, hoping something to get. So one has to find out what it is unpremeditated art, which is meditation. You understand, sir? I'll go into it. First of all, we can banish all the systems, all the methods, the postures, the breathing, forcing the mind, thought to control, and so on, so on. The controller is the controlled. Right? Thought creates the controller, and then the controller says, I must control thought in order to meditate, or rather, to meditate, which is so obviously silly. So, systems, methods, the idea of controlling thought, or thought identifying itself with something, a picture, an image, a symbol, and concentrating on that. I don't know if you're following all this. And there's this nonsensical transcendental meditation, which is really a glorified racket, money-making racket. I know you won't like some of you who probably have done this. You pay to your somebody 10 rupees or 10,000 rupees, and if you get it straight from the horse's mouth, you pay all your income. And he gives you a mantra. I've been told a mantra means, the root meaning and the depth of that word means ponder. Consider, meditate upon not becoming. And absorb, dissolve all self-centered activity. That's what that word apparently means. But look what it has become. You can repeat without going through giving off money to somebody to tell you the mantra. You can invent your own mantra. Coca-Cola? Yes, yes, sir. Don't laugh. You're all doing it. Or any other catchword. Repeat it for 20 minutes in the morning, 20 minutes in the afternoon, 20 minutes in the evening, and the rest of the day you can do all the mischief you want. Take a siesta. You understand a siesta, what it means? 20 minutes rest. Go to sleep. Put your brain to sleep by repeating, repeating, repeating. In the afternoon, so on, so on. So that's not meditation. So we're going to find out what is meditation. If you are really interested to find out, not how to meditate, what is the depth and the beauty and the reality and the immense possibility of meditation. The word means ponder, to think over, be concerned. The dictionary meaning of that word. But the word is not the thing, right? The word meditation is not meditation. And why should one meditate at all? Is meditation separate from life? That is our daily living. The office, the family, the sex, the pursuit of ambition, daily life, is that separate from meditation? Or is meditation part of life? You understand? You understand my question? Part of life. If it is separate and you meditate in order to live better life, in order to be better, follow? Then you are imposing certain concepts on actuality, certain experience of others, essentially of others, on what you think should happen. Now, if you can deny all that, you understand? Please, this is very serious what we're talking about, unless you are really very serious to go into it, don't play with it. It is to deny everything that man has thought about meditation. About silence, about truth, about eternity, whether there is a timeless state and so on. To be free of other people's knowledge completely. And that goes very, very far. That is, to deny your gods, your sacred books, your tradition, your beliefs, everything wiped away, because you understand they are the result of thought. We which means you're totally, psychologically not dependent on anything. Which means you are free of fear. No longer touched by sorrow, which doesn't mean that you become hard, bitter, cruel. And without love and compassion, there's no meditation. So life, living every day in this world, which is corrupt beyond words, which is immoral, destructive, without a sense, lack of integrity, living in that, in this world, surrounded by all this. To have that sense of total freedom, which is absolute freedom. Because you have denied everything that man has thought out, except technological world. I don't have to repeat that over and over again. Because then you are the mind, then you enter into a quite a different dimension, which is the mind. Not you enter, there is the mind. Mind is entirely different from the brain. And that mind cannot be understood or known or perceived unless the brain, with all its sensory responses, is understood. That is, to see something, see the seed, the sea, the sheet of water, or anything of nature, with all your senses. With all your senses, not with merely with your eyes or hear one thing, with all your senses. When you perceive with all your senses, there is no recalling. There is no I. It's only when we perceive something partially, then the partial thing creates the me which is partial. So, when the brain is totally free from all accumulated psychological knowledge, then there is the mind. I won't go into that. Then that becomes a theory. You understand? Unless one has done all this, actually, you can test it out. You can see it in your daily life. If that is not tested out in daily life, it is not worth it. So when there is this absolute denial of all the psychological accumulation, then the mind, when the brain becomes very quiet, it hasn't to be induced to be quiet. Then illumination is not an experience. Illumination means to see things clearly as they are and to go beyond them. And in our lives there is very little beauty. Not the beauty of form, actual beauty in our life. And that beauty cannot exist without love. And when there is love and compassion, it has its own intelligence. That intelligence acts, which is whole, which is right action. All this is meditation. And there is immense beauty in it. Great sense of aesthetic appreciation and the perception of the world. And in that there is great benediction, not from your gods, but the benediction of living a life which is whole. Yourself.